Friends, today we have amongst us Mr. P. Krishna Kumar. He is the Executive Director and General Manager for Consumer and Small Businesses Bell India. He is responsible for handling the go-to-market strategies for these business segments. Prior to this role, he was the Executive Director of Marketing and was responsible for managing overall marketing and activities across business segments. So we welcome you.
And then I have done 9.5 years of marketing. And then the 20th year, I was again back to sales and general manager for Bell in India, the consumer business. So for those of you who are looking for sales and marketing, you would have heard that sales and marketing are two sides of the coin. I'm a perfect example who spent equal amount of time on both sides. So that's one. Second is that I have had the fortune to work in interesting companies and interesting brands. Started with Wipro in the consumer division. I don't know how many of you have heard about Wipro consumer division. So I started selling bulbs.
Sir, they are also coming up with a new product,
Yogovita. You want to join FMCG? Okay, good. So, you're all new
condition.
All of you have CFL at home?
Yes.
Oh my God. Badness. Badness, you saw the
ball
there?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. And what did you go and ask? No effect on the brand, right? You went and asked 40 watt bulbs, 60 watt bulbs. Correct, Philips. So when you go and ask, saying ki meko 60 watt ka bulb chahiye, the shopkeeper will keep some brand, and then you will come back and say, Philips nahi hai kya? So I had the fortune of starting to sell Wipro bulb. This is not a government company. Are you seeing
it? The customers are satisfied. Wouldn't you also agree that a large portion of those 98% never actually tell people how satisfied they are? I mean, those 2% who are not satisfied would create a ruckus on Facebook. So people would see that, but they would never see those 98% who are happy. So isn't that a bit of negative publicity that is happening to you?
Because as an independent observer, if I go to the website and if I see negative comments,
yes,
so that will add on to my mindset.
Good. You're a marketer, what will you do about it?
So probably hide them.
Hide them?
In
I would never hide them.
So, but then they will create a negative perception about the brand.
They will. That's a fact. Perception is reality. They will. You're in the spotlight. As a marketer, you can't hide them. You can hide, but you know, it's in my mind, it's unethical. Somebody is complaining about it and you're keeping it hidden.
As a marketer, I would solve the problem and as well post it again on the same domain so that the problem is there and solution has already been provided.
Yeah, but you're being defensive now. You're right. You'll solve the problem, but you'll post it. So you're right, it gets measured. So we'll talk about measurement. But to answer your question, go ahead.
So why did you say that posting a solution would be defensive? Because I feel that as a customer, if I'm buying something, I always have that thing in mind that this product might develop some harm, no matter how big a brand it is. And when I see on the site that if a customer develops some problem, that problem is being addressed, that builds my faith even more that if 0.00% probability is that if I develop some problem with the product, that problem will be addressed.
I was being a little provocative by saying defensive, right? to try and see what your reaction will be. Yeah, it's not defensive, but is that the best that you can do? You're right. If I as a customer go and I see that, you know, XYZ had a company and this company has solved the problem and posted that they have solved the problem, I would feel positive about the plan, right?
wrong labeling or wrong phrasing of the word. Probably addressing it that then and there on the social media, and then
I can't address it then. For example, the complaint I get is my laptop is not working for the last 2 days,
right,
and the service engineer has come and not solved my problem.
Immediately, you reply that acknowledge your problem or the complaint, and then we'll get back to you probably in an hour or probably in a day. We'll resolve that problem.
And then?
And again, we post that your problem has been resolved. Probably you're satisfied with the whatever we have done for the problem.
But
can we not change the line? I mean, can we not focus on increasing the number of these 98% people who come and post actually their positive feedback? Can we not motivate them?
So that's the question I was coming to, right? Is that the best that you can do? I'm just trying to pick your idea and your idea. What you can do is two things, right? While you're addressing the customer complaint, what we do is take the customer private and say, hey, I know you've got a problem. Tell me a specific problem so I can help you. Right? Once you have solved the problem, we try and post it saying that Mr. So-and-so or Madam So-and-so, your problem has been solved. But to us, the delight is what you said, if the customer writes herself that my problem got solved, thank you. Right? That's the delight factor. And to the next point, you have 98% of happy. If you cannot delight them, if you cannot motivate them to go and write positive things about you, you fail as a marketer. You fail as a marketer. Right? Or second, they're coming up with innovation on the product which you're not able to manage. Fortunately, my category is such that it's very, what I call it, I say it's not rocket science to make a desktop, laptop, or something. Technology is very uniform for all of us. So product innovations are not usually very difficult, right? So if you are ahead of the curve, you can do a little bit. But what is exciting is if you can, like I said, the brand satisfaction comes any route to purchase, customer has an option. After sales service, we cover about close to 750 towns where in the next business day, you will get your problem solved. On site, it doesn't matter where it is. You don't have to carry your laptop and go to a service center, right? So those differentiators help us in terms of winning against competition.
Sir, talking about the campaign, so it was quite an abstract thing and it doesn't arrive, you cannot arrive on the theme or the concept obviously from the product features. So how do you decide on these themes? Because there must be something parallelly going on apart from features and you pull in both the things.
Good. So the question is that how do you make it a differentiator? Two things.
How do you decide on the theme?
According to that, achievement was a global theme. When you say self-achievement, right, you saw the achievement person, giving achievement and self-achievement. We went to self-achievement. We could have taken a global English campaign. Or we said, can we then translate this to a local market, local need? So when you say that I can do kuch bhi, right, it's a self-achievement stuff. It reinforces, right? So it fits into the global template or what you want to do. How are we differentiating? At that point in time, touch technology was coming new to laptops. And we were the first to introduce. And we still today, as of now, 6 months into introducing this, have the widest range of touch laptops and have the most price competitive touch laptops in the market. Since we knew that as a strategy we want to build on it, we said let the campaign have both celebrating youth, achievement, and the product feature that there is touch. Right? So if you see that line, it's beautiful, right? Sapno ke chune ki deri hai, right?
That's the one touch only.
Yeah, still touch. It could. We did research. You could do self-achievement many ways. For example, the other idea which came across is you could pick up 10 different sports persons or different people from different fields and say they have achieved something. Right? If you went back to 5 years back, Dell had done that on a smaller bit of business. We talked about entrepreneurs like NIIT, Mr. Raman Roy. We talked about Sanjana. We talked about a campaign where we talked about individual achievement. So since you have done that in the past, we didn't do so many exact things. But that's the result again which goes on.
So you talked about brand promiseability. Where you said that what you can deliver, that only you promise. So now we have worked in domains like Pepsi and Intel. So do you feel that the product always comes first in a B2C scenario and then you build on the brand? Or is it such that you can create perceptions through brand and then you might have a slightly less functional product?
Okay. To go along a brand benefit ladder, there are two elements to it. Emotional benefit and functional benefit. Right? Let me just go back to that. Because you bring up a very valid point. Right? there's an emotional benefit and a functional benefit to the customer. You have to satisfy the customer on both. Functional benefit is again a necessary but not sufficient condition. Emotional benefit gets you to the bonding, which will be done.